This is the Tom Anderson Show, broadcasting live from the KVNT studios in South Central Alaska, USA. Live and local 7 to 9 a.m., Monday through Friday, right here on KVNT 1020 a.m. and 92.5 FM. Your best source for morning news, traffic, and weather. Streaming live online at TomAndersonShow.com. Phone lines are open. Dial 907-357-5868. That's 357-5868. Politics and news from a guy who's made it happen. Your morning drive just got a whole lot better. Good morning, America. Here's Tom Anderson.
8:06 a.m. Good morning, everybody. Happy, happy Monday. Rick Milliken, good morning. How was your weekend?
Fantastic. It was gorgeous. 60, just perfect. All my snow is finally gone.
We're about 95% done. Couple berms from snow plowing, but yep, same thing.
Yeah, and the ground's still pretty soggy, but I was able to get some stuff done. Had a little fire in the fire pit last night.
We're about to do that this week. That's cleared and open. We've been raking and just, it's a delight. Spring is here. The birds are chirping. The sun's out. We're going to have 60, low 60s this week. Senator Laura Reinbold, thanks for joining us. Headline news, it just made Fox News that you've been banned, at least temporarily, from Alaska Airlines. I texted you, thanks for calling in. I don't get it. What exactly happened? Do you have time to explain?
Well, I will talk to you at a very high level. As you know, House Bill 76 is on the Senate floor this morning. My legislative duties are my top priority, and I've got a lot of things to expose in regards to that bill. It's the most divisive bill of the session. That's what was critical that I got down here. I thought the timing of the ban was very interesting. I will put that on the table for you. I will tell you that I did have a mask. I have a mask exemption. I simply inquired about the mask exemption downstairs, and there were some uptight employees, and I ended up putting the mask on, wearing it, and I wore it in the waiting area. I sat quietly up there at the waiting area. I will tell you that I got confronted by an uptight employee upstairs, completely unprovoked. She just came and talked to me, and I'm not going to get into the details of that. And then again, someone barked at me at the counter, and I pulled my mask up. I was really bizarre because there were so many people surrounding me. It was interesting how it all played out. But then I ended up just trying to figure out who all these people were around me. And then I ended up, that's when you'll see in the video. I was just trying to figure out who all these people were.
Is that the video on landmine?
Going and just getting on the gate, going to the gate, because interestingly, that when all this was being videoed, I had been paged, which I thought was quite interesting. Interestingly, a video showed up. That was another interesting thing. And then the news knew everything, you know, so quickly. I was blown away. And then I didn't get an email until Saturday, which I thought, again, that was interesting. And then I had to quickly figure out a way to get to Juneau because no one talked to me, you know, in regards to Alaska Airlines. I just got an email. It was just completely blew me away that they wouldn't even get my side of the story, didn't do due process, and yet they issued a punishment, just like what the governor basically did and what happened in judiciary was very interesting. Well, anyway, I did wear a mask on the flight. I know that the story's being twisted, even with the mask exemption. Again, I wore it in the waiting area. I wore it right after the flight. The agent told me I wore it in the waiting area. I wore it on the plane. So this story is really getting, a different portrayal than what actually happened. But I will tell you, there's a lot of red flags, and we will be looking into it.
And Alaska State Senator Laura Reinbold joining us. So you were in Anchorage, the biggest city in Alaska, headed to our capital in Juneau, or vice versa?
I had left Juneau, and I was heading back to Anchorage.
I see. And so were you able to get on that flight?
Yeah. No problem at all. Lovely flight attendants. Lovely pilots. I always thank the pilots. I try every time I get off the flight to thank them. A couple weeks ago, I ended up flying, and I even brought the flight attendants chocolates. It was great. I mean, I have decades of flight experience on Alaska Airlines.
Well, you're gold,
MVP,
aren't you?
Gold.
You're MVP,
oh, yeah,
gold.
MVP gold.
And then coming back, so are you in Anchorage now? Because, of course, headline news is Laura Reinbold, Senator Reinbold, temporarily banned on Alaska Airlines. So if you landed in Anchorage last week into the weekend, are you back in Juneau? Do they allow you to fly back, or are you stuck here in your city of Eagle River Chugiak?
Well, it's a temporary until things are looked into. So that's why I didn't think it was fair that they made this judgment, knowing that I'm a senator, knowing that I had legislative work, knowing that this is the end of session, and I believe Alaska has a contract, with the state. So there's a lot of red flags here to look into, but I will tell you that I reached new heights in getting...
No pun intended.
Getting back here. Yes, exactly. To get back here in Juneau. So my husband, on his birthday weekend, he is my knight in shining armor. He drove with me. We got through Canada, got on a ferry, and I got in last night.
You drove all the way to Canada. How many miles was that?
I think it was about 750 miles total that we drove, and plus a 4 or 5 hour ferry trip.
And through Canada. And any problems at the border going through Canada with vaccinations or masks or any of that?
I got through the border. Yep, they were, it was good. In regards to no issues. It was really beautiful driving. I will tell you, we got to see caribou on the road. We got to see tons of moose. We got to see killer whales as we pulled into Juneau last night. We saw orcas, porpoises. It was amazing.
Boy, is your husband a great guy. Your husband's saying, honey, if you can't fly, we'll drive almost 800 miles through another country to get to the Capitol. So you're back at work. I'm impressed with that.
Yep. And we got House Bill 76. There was nobody that was going to get in my way with House Bill 76. So that is the most divisive bill by far.
And what's the subject matter before we let you go? Because I know you have to go.
The disaster declaration. That basically, the disaster declaration, it retroactives the governor's illegal disaster declarations. So there's serious legal issues with that. So it goes back to November 2020. It goes forward all the way till 2022, till January 1st, 2022, or December 31st, 2021. It gives the Commissioner of Health and Social Services power to declare an emergency, and it gives him power over all the therapeutics and the vaccinations, the mRNA therapeutics for COVID.
So what is your message to the public? We got 20 seconds left. What are you asking them to do, to write to
follow,
whom?
First of all, follow my Facebook. Follow my Senator Laura Reinbold and Empowering Alaskans Facebook. Second, call every single legislator and email every single legislator and tell them vote no on 76. That's an urgent SOS. And I have the reasons why, posted about a week ago up on my Facebook.
On your Facebook page, State today. Senator Laura Reinbold. We'll make a YouTube video. We'll see if they cancel this one too, but we'll put it on Facebook as well. Laura, thank you for your time. I'm glad you made it safe back to Juneau. Going to come right back, my friends. Tom Anderson Show. Good morning.